Hey, crafty friends, thank you very much for joining me. This is Einat Kessler with Saturday Extravaganza, and today we are altering. I have here all kinds of boxes and toilet paper rolls that I have covered with one coat of gesso, and I'm gonna create a desk organizer from them, and it's a great way to utilize all your unwanted packages, toilet paper rolls, and things like that. So I'm going to show you how to cover boxes and toilet paper rolls in two different ways. First, I'm going to use old book papers. Now, since this book is very old, the pages are really thin and almost like tissue paper. So I'm using Mod Podge, and I'm putting a layer of Mod Podge all over the outer part of the box, and in the inside, just where I need to fold it in to have a nice edge. And I'm just gluing down the paper on the box. Make sure in the bottom to fold it nicely to have a nice edge, and in the inside I'm just rolling, folding it to the inside so the outer edge will look nice. So I'm just going in stages. So I finished one page and I'm adding the next page, and I'm gonna go and continue with this until the whole box is covered. And using a wide brush is very helpful to apply the Mod Podge. And I'm not going to cover the paper with Mod Podge on the outside after I glue them down as a sealer, like you can do with Mod Podge, because it's a sealer also, because I still want to do stuff to them and I don't want it to be sticky, because sometimes Mod Podge takes a long time to dry. So maybe after I'm finished completely with the entire project, I'm going to go ahead and cover that. So I've just teared the edges, the edge on one side of my book paper, because sometimes the margins where the area that has no script on it is kind of wide, so I want to avoid that by tearing that empty space that I have on the page. And I really like how yellow the pages are, because this book is so old. Tearing the margins there. And so my first box is covered. I'm not going to cover the bottom part because that's going to be glued down and it's not going to be visible, so there's no point. Okay, so for the next method, we did that with the toilet paper roll steampunk mini album, if you remember. If you want to use just a regular double-sided cardstock, it's really hard to cover it with anything because it's very stiff and thick and difficult to work with. So what we're going to do is turn it into a sort of a tissue paper by breaking all the fibers in the paper and getting them wet. So what I'm going to do, I'm spritzing the paper with some water, and I'm crumbling it and open it, and I'm going to do this about two or three times and making sure it's all dry until the paper becomes very soft and flexible and easy to work with, almost like fabric. So crumble it again, open it. This breaks the fibers of the paper and the water, so the water helps. So now I have a very, very flexible paper that is still intact. Work very gently with it because it can tear very easily. So I've just cut it in half because I don't need such a big piece of paper. And since it's not like the pages that I have to do it in steps, this is a large piece of paper, so I'm just going to cover it all around And I'm just pressing down so everything will be nice and straight. Glue down very well to the box. We want a nice even surface. We don't want any bubbles. And I just need one more small piece to fit in my empty space there. So just add the last piece. And if you have some Mod Podge showing like me, don't worry about it because it dries clear. This is the bottom. Fold it nicely to have a nice edge. Burnish it well so there will be no bubbles or wrinkles. And I recommend working on a craft mat, so if you have some Mod Podge on your fingers or anywhere or on the box and the paper, this way it will be easy to clean and nothing will stick to your desk. So I'm folding the edges of the paper to the inside of the box so I'll have a nice edge. So this is the second box that is covered. Now I'm gonna prepare this piece of paper as well, like I did the last one, the other piece, and I'm gonna cover that with, I'm gonna cover the toilet paper rolls with this paper as well. These are Tim Holtz papers. Specifically, the ideology destinations papers. So I'm covering it more or less to size. I'm leaving about half an inch on each side or an inch. And I'm just applying the Mod Podge on my toilet paper roll and rolling it with the paper. And it's covered very, very fast and very easily. Now you might wonder why I covered everything with gesso. Toilet paper rolls and boxes, they're very thin and I just wanted another layer to give them a little bit more stiffness, and in case I'm using something like the old book papers, which are very thin, I didn't want the pattern or the color of the box to show. So this way I had a clean slate to work with because everything was white. So now I've finished covering everything, 9 toilet paper rolls and 2 boxes, and I have this box here that I covered on the outside as well, and I'm going to glue down all my toilet paper rolls and boxes inside that wide box, which is going to be sort of a tray that everything's going to fit in, and that's going to be my organizer. Now since it's going to be a steampunk organizer, you can imagine that we're going to add all kinds of fun embellishments later, which I'm not going to go very crazy with because this organizer is kind of big, and if I would want to cover it all with embellishments, that would be too many embellishments, and I don't want to use so many supplies. But I am going to decorate it and it's going to look really nice. So I'm just adding all my boxes. And you actually don't have to have that bottom box. You can just glue everything to everything and without that sort of a tray. But I don't know, that gives it a definition and a frame, and I like it this way. So this is how it looks from the side. I'm gonna go over it with some distress ink to give it a little bit more brown colors and sort of dirt I covered the bottom as well. I don't know why. It's gonna stand on the bottom. Nobody's gonna see it, but I don't know. I just had some Mod Podge there. It was sticky. I put some papers on it, and that's how it got covered. You really don't need to cover the bottom. So go over all the edges with some distress ink, and we can start with the embellishments. So I have here a leather strap. You know that leather is smooth on one side and then kind of has texture on the outside, like sort of a fur kind of texture. So I'm gonna add this strap all around that very short tray of a box, and I'm gonna glue down the part that has no texture, and I want the part that has texture to show. So the shinier, smoother side is gonna be glued down so it won't show. So I'm gonna go all around with this strap. You can do this with a ribbon or with a piece of paper. And I'm gonna trim the excess off. And I'm gonna start adding some embellishments. This is a really heavy old key that I got from some flea market, and I'm gonna stick it in there because there are little holes because of the shape of the toilet paper rolls, which is round. So I have some room to stick things in. So this is a glass vial, and I'm gonna use another glass vial in another place. And from the side, it's gonna look really cool. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with the large pieces of embellishments, and you would have to add them while the organizer is sort of lying down, because you need to wait for the glue to dry, otherwise they will fall, because some of the embellishments, at least the ones I'm using, are kinda heavy. So I'm gonna glue the large embellishments on one side, wait for it to dry so they will hold and not fall, and then turn it and do the other side, wait again until it's dry, and then do the third side. I'm not going to do the back side because I'm going to put it on my desk next to the wall, and I don't need to put anything on the back side. So I've added a clock and some gears and a spring and all kinds of metal stuff that you already know that I love and that I get here and there. And after a few minutes that it was drying, I can turn it and go ahead and do the other side, the front side, or depends how you're gonna present it on your desk. So I've just punched a hole with my crop-a-dial, and I'm gonna add these cool clasps or chains or whatever you call them by Tim Holtz. And that other part with the hook has it has adhesive on it, so it just glues down to wherever you put it, so it's really cool. And this is sort of a handle, and I'm gonna wait for this to dry, turn it over, and do the other side. So I'm gonna add some stuff, and just to let you know that I have no planning here. I've just picked up a few of the embellishments that I like, and I'm just thinking where to put them as I go along. So there is no right or wrong here, you guys. You can just put whatever you have wherever you want it, just to embellish it and make it nice and steampunky. So these are all kinds of stuff that I have that I get here and there. And actually people have asked me if I'm willing to sell some of them, so I'm thinking about it. Maybe I'll open a steampunk shop or something so you guys can get these stuff too, because they're really cute and fun and pretty, and I like them very much. You know I love to work with them. So adding the stuff, waiting for it to dry. This is a cap of a pipe of some sort that I don't even know where I got. This is a lamp, a small lamp that you use in your car. Then I'm going to add up here. And I'm going to show you a really nice trick. You just take a wire and a pencil and you just roll it around your pencil like this, and then you get a really cool nice spring that you can add to your project. So it's a really fast and fun and easy and inexpensive way to just create a spring. You can of course determine the diameter of the spring depending on what you're going to roll it on. So it can be wider or narrower, or you know, whatever you want. So I'm gonna add this one, the spring here, in between the toilet paper rolls. And you remember that the glue dries clear, so don't worry about that. And I have some words here that are actually beads that I really like to add because they're fun. And after they're glued down, I'm gonna go ahead and make them a little bit dirtier with some black ink, which I'm gonna add later when I'm finished. So I'm just creating a tower here of these word bricks, which are actually beads like I said before. And they have play, laugh, smile, you know, positive, fun words. And it's my tower. And some wooden, these are numbers, also by Tim Holtz. Just have this screw, thinking of putting it here. And I'm now starting to fill the spaces in between the large items, the large embellishments, with some smaller embellishments that I can now go ahead and add. And make it look really nice and fun. And that would have to be dry before I turn it over and work on the other side, because even the tiniest of embellishments can fall if the glue is not completely dry. Just adding things inside that cap there. There you go. Oops, that fell up. Now it's the right direction. So I hope you know what I meant when I said, you know, you can go wild with embellishing the entire thing, and that will just take a long time and so many supplies, and you have to stop at some point. So I'm not gonna add too much more stuff on this side. Just a tiny little bit. Now, while I was working, I've added the word art that I've inked a little bit with black ink. These are chipboard letters, and I've decided to color all of the boxes and toilet paper rolls with black acrylic paint and add some washi tape on the edges. because even though they're going to be filled with water, you know, with colored pencils and brushes and everything, I still don't want that inside white, you know, color to show. So I've covered it completely with black acrylic ink. And just to have a nice finish, I've added washi tape of two patterns on the inside, on the edge. So you missed that part because I didn't film it, but it's kind of self-explanatory. It's not. Just take a brush and paint. So I'm adding some little stuff, and I'm going to add some letter stickers here as well and spell the word create, because we have art on one side and this is going to be create on the other side. So I'm going to add the letters. And if I see I don't have an E, I'm just taking three, the digits, the number three, and I'm just turning it over, and that looks like an E. Okay, so this is how it looks. See all the, I've added this thing here that hangs on the edge of the box with some things hanging from it, and everything is colored in black and has washi tape on the inside. And here are all the embellishments, and of course you can add many more embellishments, but basically I think it's enough for me at this point. And we have all the glass vials and the letters that we've added and all the other embellishments. So I hope you like this project. It's an upcycling, steampunk, crafty, beautiful, fun project to make. And I hope you were inspired and that you won't throw away your empty packages. Just use them for something and create a really useful project. So thank you very, very much for joining me on this tutorial, and I'll see you all next time.